Hello, wrestling fans. Jay Lauderdale here from the Wrestling Life Support Podcast, and we're coming at you today with something fun, something a little unique. You know, here at the Wrestling Life Support Podcast, the only thing that we like more than professional wrestling is professional wrestling fantasy booking. And the only thing we like more than fantasy booking is Fire Pro Wrestling World. So we wanted to put all that together and give you, the fans, the opportunity to create some amazing matchups, and we would show it right here on the Wrestling Life Support YouTube channel. So we sent out a call to action to all of our fans. We got tons of tweets, tons of emails, and we picked the top 8 matches from our fan community here, and we're going to air it on the YouTube channel. Whatever happens, happens. We hope this is the first of many, but this will be a 16-wrestler tournament to crown the first ever Wrestling Life Support fan champion. And the only rules that we threw out there, the wrestlers had to be real and had to have at least one match in a major promotion. We didn't want to get into the independent realm because, you know, to be honest with you, it'd have been hard to find really reputable creations in Fire Pro Wrestling World. But it's our favorite game. We love it. We've been a fan of the Fire Pro franchise for a long time. And so this is our little gift to you guys. Once again, Jay Lauderdale, Wrestling Life Support Podcast. Check us out on social media at WLS Podcast. Please go find our podcast on whatever service that you use. Subscribe, leave us a positive review. It really helps. And now let's talk about the bracket itself. So what we decided to do was take our 4 favorite tweets and our 4 favorite emails, and those determined the matches in the first round. On one side of the bracket, it's the top tweets. On the other side of the bracket, it's the top emails. So onto the Twitter side of the bracket. The first one comes to us from Eric Thomas. He says, please do the greatest of all time Hulk Hogan versus the best of the greatest of all time tag team, the Legion of Doom, Hawk. So that's going to be a heavy-hitting first matchup. Wow. I mean, Hulk Hogan against Road Warrior Hawk, I think that's on anybody's must-watch list. The second tweet comes to us from AEW Vintage Baby, who says, love the review of AEW Double or Nothing. Want to make the dream match happen. Arn versus Jake. Spinebuster versus DDT. Book it. Okay, well, we can do that, and that will be an excellent first-round matchup of two legends that have never faced each other. The third tweet comes to us from Strong Style Redneck. He says, my two passions are New Japan and Jim Cornette. WLS could be a third. Well, thank you, Strong Style Redneck. We hope so. I want to see the man, Thunder Liger, and Jim's favorite, Beautiful Bobby. Now, that's an all-time dream match. I don't think anybody would disagree with that. Jushin Thunder Liger against Beautiful Bobby Eaton. Two different styles, but both amazing wrestlers, and the world of professional wrestling wouldn't be where it is today without those amazing two talents. And the last tweet's a good one. This comes to us from Lucha Tomas. He says, Mil Mascaras versus star of this season of Dark Side of the Ring, Dr. D. Will Mil sell? Well, I don't know if he will, but Fire Pro is going to tell us, and I have a feeling that Dr. D might give him all that he can handle. So what an amazing, weird, odd, crazy matchup to round out the first half of the bracket. So on the email side of the bracket, these are some good ones. So this comes to us from Ed L. in Sturgis, South Dakota. I didn't know people lived in Sturgis. He writes, my son is just now getting into AEW. He loves Brian Cage. My favorite is Okada, assuming he means Kazuchika Okada. I'd love to see them duke it out on Fire Pro. Well, Ed, we can make that happen and consider this match booked. The second email comes to us from Devon or Devon in Murfreesboro, Tennessee. And he writes, or she writes, let's see if the best bout machine can pull a good match with Abdullah or get forked. Well, I know that he means Abdullah the Butcher with the fork reference, and that, my friends, might be the oddest match in the tournament. You have the hardcore icon, the hardcore originator, the madman from Sudan, Abdullah the Butcher, against the cleaner, a guy that's put on 6-star matches all over the world, Kenny Omega. Wow, that's an interesting one. The next email comes to us from Dashing Daryl from Utica, New York. He writes, the best of two generations, Bruno versus Sting, would be so cool. I got Bruno. Well, Bruno has a great chance of pulling that out. He's one of the greatest of all time, and Sting is right there with him. There'll be some good sportsmanship and some handshaking in that one. But yeah, what a great visual to see Bruno Sammartino against the icon Sting. And the last email comes to us from Cha-Cha. What a name, Cha-Cha, from Foster City, California. My dream match is Owen Hart against CM Punk. Would be a 6-star every night out. You have to do it. Well, Cha-Cha, if we have to, we will. So that is going to be the 8th and final match of this tournament. Owen Hart against CM Punk. Wow, I think that's going to be a technical masterpiece with two really great talents. Holy cow, what a first round of the tournament. And before we get underway, let's recap the first round of the tournament. In the opening match, we have the six-time WWF, six-time WCW World Heavyweight Champion. That's right, the Immortal Hulk Hogan going up against one half of what most consider the greatest tag team of all time, the Road Warriors, and that would be Road Warrior Hawk. In the second match, we get famed NWA WCW tag team and television champion, the enforcer Arn Anderson, AA, the master of the Spinebuster, and he will meet a man that needs no introduction, the master of the DDT, Jake the Snake Roberts. In the third match, you get the legend of Lucha Libre, famed actor and wrestler Mil Mascaras, against Dr. D, David Schultz, who made a great living terrorizing the territories, the WWF in the early to mid 80s, as well as Stampede up in Calgary. He is one of the baddest dudes on the planet. Up fourth is a match that would be considered a dream match in any era or anywhere in the world, and that's between beautiful Bobby Eaton, most famously of the Midnight Express, and the Pride of Huntsville will be going up against an 11-time IWGP Junior Heavyweight Champion and a man who's captured junior heavyweight titles in every promotion he's been in and a true pioneer of wrestling, Jushin Thunder Liger. In the fifth match, we get a massive clash of styles as the originator of hardcore, the madman from the Sudan, Abdullah the Butcher, and his fork go up against the best bout machine, Kenny Omega the Cleaner, one of the stalwarts of modern professional wrestling, and a six-star match every time he goes out there. In what should be a hard-hitting sixth contest, you have the pride of New Japan, Kazuchika Okada, considered by many to be the best wrestler in the world today, up against the machine who's terrorized Lucha Underground, Impact, AEW, that is Brian Cage. In the seventh match, you get a cross-generational dream match. One of the greatest WWF champions of all time, Bruno Sammartino, against the master of the Scorpion Deathlock and a man who carried WCW on his shoulders for so long, the Icon. This is Sting. In the first round finale, you get one of the most controversial and beloved superstars of the modern era, CM Punk, going up against one of the most gifted wrestlers of his generation and part of the Hart family dynasty. You can call him the King of Hearts, you can call him the Rocket, but it's Owen Hart. And now let's start this tournament.
You can't escape.
Thank you. Thank you. Come on. Thank you.
And there you have it, folks. The Immortal Hulk Hogan, one of the favorites, has won the first ever Wrestling Life Support Fantasy Tournament. Wow, what a tournament it was. If you like what we're doing at the Wrestling Life Support Podcast, our pay-per-view and big event reviews, our Return to the Coliseum segments where we review old Coliseum Home videos, our Dream Card series, and of course, the Enhancement Talent of the Week, then please follow us on social media, hit like, hit subscribe. Also, whatever podcast service provider that you're using, please subscribe to us and leave a positive review. It really helps the cause. Thank you so much. I'm Jay Lauderdale. I'll see you next time.